Hi friends, in previous chapter we completed hydraulic turbines of Pelton-Wheel Francis turbine and its part of draft tube and its conventional equations and turbine performance. Now today's topic is a centrifugal pump. So first of all we discuss about the pump. What is the pump? Pump is nothing but a mechanical device which converts. So pump which converts, this pump which converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. So it is just a reverse of a turbine. So turbine, the turbine also mechanical device which converts hydraulic energy to the mechanical energy. So pump is nothing but it is also mechanical device which converts mechanical energy into the hydraulic energy. So the turbine and pump is just a vice versa device. In turbine, the turbine produces a work, and the pump absorbs works, means it uses the mechanical energy. So that mechanical energy we supplied here in the turbine, the hydraulic energy is converted into mechanical energy. While the turbine shaft is coupled to the generator. This is a turbine. The shaft of this turbine is when you couple to the generator, it produces a electrical energy. So for rotating this mechanical shaft of turbine, we supply a hydraulic energy. This hydraulic energy is converted easily as a mechanical energy by rotating a shaft. So when the shaft of this turbine is coupled to the generator, what happened? The generator is converted into the electrical energy, mechanical energy to the electrical energy. So this is a function of a turbine. So while here the turbine is produces work, but as in case of centrifugal pump, it absorbs work, means the pump is converted mechanical energy into hydraulic energy, which required a mechanical energy for conversion of hydraulic energy. We required a shaft of work. The shaft of work we are extracting from a motor. So that motor, what motor develops, the motor we are supplying electrical energy. The motor is converted electrical energy to the mechanical energy. That mechanical energy of shaft energy we are coupled to the shaft pump, the impeller of a pump. Then what happened? The impeller receives the mechanical energy and it converts the hydraulic energy by pumping a liquid from a lower head to higher head. So what happened? The hydraulic energy in terms of converted into the pressure energy. So what happened? The pump is use the mechanical energy by extracting the shaft work from a motor. That mechanical energy is converted to hydraulic energy by lifting water. This means increasing the pressure energy. The pressure energy is in terms of increase the potential energy by lifting the water from lower source to higher source. So simply says that the pump is a mechanical device which converts mechanical energy to hydraulic energy by raising the pressure in a impeller or any chamber, and then it is converted into potential energy to lift by lifting a water from lower source to higher source. So this is a centrifugal pump. So coming to pumps are two types. The first one is a positive displacement pump. And the second one is a rotodynamic pump. In a positive displacement pump, the water is sucked in a chamber, then it is pushed by a plunger or a ram mechanism. An example of a positive displacement pump is a reciprocating pump. It's look like a IC engine. So the fluid is sucked by the, so it is a chamber, it is a plunger or a piston mechanism. So this is a suction valve and this is a delivery valve. There is a two non-retaining valve is placed. One it is a suction valve and suction pipe, and another it is a delivery pipe. So this is a positive displacement pump. Means the fluid is sucked by a sucked into the chamber. In this chamber. So when the pump, when this piston is moves towards the rightward, the fluid is sucked into this chamber. Then what happened? Then when the piston is toward moves to again the left towards backward or leftward, then this non-retaining valve of the suction pipe is closed. Then in this the fluid present in this chamber is pushed by this piston to the delivery valve. This is called positive displacement pump. So the example of this positive displacement pump is a reciprocating pump. This means the positive displacement, the fluid is sucked to the chamber, then pushed by this plunger mechanism or ram mechanism. So example is a reciprocating pump. So while in the rotor dynamics pump, it is a simply impeller mechanism. It is a simply impeller mechanism. In this, the fluid is entered to the rotating impeller. This is a impeller. So this is a backward shape of vane shape of impeller. So in this impeller eye, the water is entered into the impeller eye. So due to centrifugal action, when it is a rotating, so this impeller is attached or coupled to the motor shaft. While it is rotating, what happened? The blades are creating a centrifugal effect. Then this centrifugal effect, the water is send away to the this outlet of a delivery valve. So this is a rotor dynamic pump. So rotor dynamic pumps does not push the liquid like central reciprocating pump. Does not pushes the fluid or liquid as in case of a reciprocating pump or positive displacement pump. So the rotor dynamic pumps, the liquid passes, its angular momentum changes due to the pressure energy of liquid is increases. So rotor dynamic pumps does not push the liquid as in case of a positive displacement pump. So example of this rotor dynamic pumps is a centrifugal pump. So nothing but radial flow pumps. So radial flow pumps, axial flow pump, and mixed flow pump as turbines. So radial flow pump is nothing but a centrifugal pump. Axial flow pump is a propeller pump. Axial flow pump is nothing but the example of axial pump is a propeller pump. Propeller pump and a mixed flow pump is a screw pump. So these are the three types of pumps. So this is a positive displacement pump. This is a rotor dynamic pump. In a positive displacement, the liquid is sucked into the chamber, then pushed into the delivery valve. But in a rotor dynamic pump, the fluid is entered to the circular type of impeller. Then it is a when it is rotating, the centrifugal effect is created. Then the liquid is pushed or the liquid is sent to the delivery valve. So there is no pushing action of pushing action on the fluid or liquid by this impeller. So this is the example rotor dynamic pump. So example is a radial flow pump, axial flow pump, and mixed pump. So for radial flow pump, centrifugal pump is a radial flow pump. For axial pump, or propeller pump is a axial flow pump. Screw pump is a mixed flow pump. For positive displacement, reciprocating pump is a example for the positive displacement pump. So coming to the classifications of centrifugal pumps. Then classifications of centrifugal pump. Classifications. Though the centrifugal pumps can be classified into three types. The first one is a radial flow centrifugal pumps, and second one is a radial flow pumps. Not centrifugal. Classifications of rotor dynamic pumps. So the rotor dynamic pumps can be classified into radial flow pumps, axial flow pump, mixed flow pump. So all these are rotor dynamic pumps uses an impeller. So this is all called an impeller eye. So this is a impeller. So the impeller having the backward shape radial vanes or radial plates, radial vanes. This is a impeller. So the radial flow, the flow path is completely radial. The flow path is a radial direction. Means the water enters to the impeller and leaves from the impeller is both is a radial direction. So means the water enters radially and the water enters the impeller is radially and leaves also radially. That is called radial flow pump. This is just a radial flow pump. Example is centrifugal pump is a radial flow pump. So radial flow pump is just a reverse of outward flow reaction turbine. Outward flow reaction turbine, just a reverse of outward flow reaction turbine. So in radial flow pumps, the flow path of liquid is a radial direction. Means both entry of the fluid to the impeller and leaving from the impeller is a radial direction. So it is just a reverse of outward flow radial flow outward flow reaction turbine. So nothing but old Francis is the outward flow reaction turbine. So in the outward flow reaction turbine, the water enters the center of the impeller or center of the turbine blade, so then leaves towards out is called outward flow reaction turbine. Already explained how outward flow reaction turbine works in a previous turbine class. So just like this outward flow reaction turbine, the water enters the impeller eye as a radial direction. So inlet also radial direction, leaving also radial direction. So this is a radial flow pump. Means the flow path is both or radial direction, both inlet and outlet. Example is a centrifugal pump. In axial flow pump, the water enters to the impeller and leaves from the impeller is a axial direction. So it is also just a reverse of axial flow turbine. Example of axial flow turbine is a Kaplan or propeller turbine. So but is a reverse of turbine. The turbine is produces a mechanical work, but a pump uses mechanical work and convert into hydraulic energy. So the flow path of both inlet to the water and exit from the impeller is an axial direction. Means axial means parallel to the shaft axis. So the water enters parallel to the shaft axis and leaves also parallel to the shaft axis. This is called axial flow pump. So the example of axial flow pump is a propeller pump. So coming to the mixed flow, the flow path of fluid to the impeller and leaves from the impeller is two different directions. So it's maybe inlet may be axial or exit may radial or vice versa. This means enter to the impeller is a radial or exit from the impeller may be axial. So vice versa, there is a two types of flow paths is there. So the water enters axially to the blade or impeller into the impeller eye and leaves is a radially. So there is a two types of flow. One is radial, another one is axial, another one is a radial. Or vice versa, the water enters the impeller is a radial and leaves from the impeller is axial. So this is a mixed flow pump, just a reverse of mixed flow turbine of old Francis. So old Francis is a mixed flow turbine. So in the mixed flow old Francis turbine, the water enters radially and leaves axially. So just like of reverse of this, the water enters axially and leaves radially, or enters radially or leaves axially. So this is a mixed flow pump. Example of a mixed flow pump is a screw pump is a example of a mixed flow pump. For radial flow pump, centrifugal pump is an example. For axial flow pump, propeller pump is an example. For mixed flow pump, screw pump is an example. These are the classifications of a rotodynamic pump. In the rotodynamic pump, only impeller is used. But in a positive displacement, a chamber, it's maybe single chamber or multi-chamber may be used. So these are the rotodynamic pump. The rotodynamic pump is nothing but it is a rotatory impeller is used. In this impeller, a backward shape of vanes is used in this impeller. So this is called impeller eye. This is impeller eye, this is impeller, and this is impeller blades. So these are the classifications of rotodynamic pumps. So then our next topic is centrifugal pumps. What are the advantages of centrifugal pump over your reciprocating pump? The first advantage is the cost is very less. First one is cost is less. The cost of centrifugal pump is very lesser than the reciprocating pump. And second one, size. Size is very less. Centrifugal pump size is very lesser than the reciprocating pump. And third one is compact. It is very less compact than reciprocating pump. And fourth one, weight. Weight is very lesser than reciprocating pump. So these are the main dimensional part of advantages. And coming through the working part and installation capacity. Installation is very easy than reciprocating pump. And second one is, next one is discharge capacity. Discharge capacity is more than reciprocating pump. And next one, it can be handled any type of liquids. It's maybe viscous nature or non-viscous. So both viscous and non-viscous fluids can be handled. And performance characteristic curves are superior than reciprocating pump. And next, the cavitation problem is very less. Cavitation problem can be easily eliminated. And last one, it can be directly coupled to the electric motor. Directly coupled to the electric motor. So these are the advantages of centrifugal pump over the reciprocating. The first one, cost is very less than reciprocating pump. Size is also very lesser than a reciprocating pump. So compact is very less compact than reciprocating pump. Weight is very lesser than reciprocating pump. Installation is very easier than reciprocating pump. Discharge is more than in a reciprocating pump. And it can be handled any type of liquid. Both viscous and non-viscous fluids can be easily handled by centrifugal pump. And performance characteristics very superior than reciprocating pump. And cavitation problems can be easily handled or eliminated in a centrifugal pump. And it can be directly coupled to the electric motor. But in a reciprocating pump, we cannot directly couple to the electric motor. By using a belt drive, we can couple to the electric motor or oil engines. So these are the introduction of pumps and classifications of pump, classification of rotodynamic pump, and advantages of reciprocating pumps. So, and coming to the next topic, what are the main parts of centrifugal pump and what are the working principle of a centrifugal pump. Yeah, these are the components of centrifugal pump. This is a centrifugal pump line diagram, centrifugal pump diagram. Now I will explain one by one the components. First one, impeller. So completely this portion is called complete impeller. Circular shape and this one. So from this part to this complete arrangement, this circular disc is called impeller. In the impeller there is a vanes is there, like it is a radial flow turbine. These are the impeller blades or vanes, backward shape impeller blades and casing. This is a casing, this portion is completely, this is a casing, this portion up to here, this is a casing. Suction pipe, this is a suction pipe. The suction pipe is connected to the impeller eye and delivery pipe. The delivery pipe is connected to the casing of any pump. And delivery pipe, these are the four main components of or main parts of major parts of a centrifugal pump. So let us discuss one by one. So impeller, this impeller is nothing but a rotating disc having a backward shape of blades is called impeller. In the impeller, the inner portion of the impeller is called impeller eye, where it is the fluid is entered from the sump and entered from the sump through the suction valve. So the water is this is a sump is the sump. The centrifugal pump is mainly used for the lifting of water from lower source to higher source. The major centrifugal pumps, all we are using our home, most of the pumps are the centrifugal pumps. The liquid the sump is maybe either a river or a lake or any well, so or any underground. Most of my example is we are in our home, we are using a centrifugal pump, the lifting of water from under level to our upper head tank. So that sump is called either underground, so where the water is available to lift out or taken out the water of centrifugal pump is called sump. So the underground of water is called sump. So in industry the pumps is mostly used for lifting of water from a well or river or any lake to the our required operations or our requirement. So in the most of cases in our home also we are using centrifugal pump. We are using nowadays is a submersible pump. The submersible pump is also one type of centrifugal pump. So mostly the centrifugal pump is working on a action of centrifugal action. So centrifugal action means whenever rotating, for example a disc is rotating, in a manner while rotating in this disc, while you put or when you pour any particles or any liquid on this disc, what happen due to centrifugal action, the liquid may be thrown out from the center of this axis is called a centrifugal action. Take an example, if you take a stone by tying a rope while rotating this rope, when you suddenly leave out the rope, what happen due to centrifugal action, the stone is move away from the center of our rotating axis. So this is a centrifugal pump. So due to centrifugal action the pump is working, that's why it is called as a centrifugal pump. Components of a centrifugal pump, so it's completely run by a centrifugal effect or centrifugal action. So these are this is a suction pipe. To the suction pipe we are arranging or connected to the strainer. This strainer is used to purify or straining off large impurities while entered to the suction pipe. So just this is because of used for straining or purification of impurities. So generally while water entered to the suction pipe, large dust particles or large mud particles are also entered in the suction pipe. So while using this strainer, the large particles are stopped at here, only liquid particles are entered to the suction pipe. So while entered to the suction pipe, that there is a, while rotating this impeller, what happened? The suction is created in impeller I. Due to the suction created, the water is entered to the impeller. So the impeller I. So then impeller I to the water is a water is entered to the impeller blades. Due to centrifugal effect, the impeller blades are pushed or create a tangential velocity component. Then the water is entered to the casing of this centrifugal pump. So this is a impeller. The next part is a casing. So while entered to the casing, this case you observe this, this casing is a gradually increasing cross section. This type of casing is a volute casing. So in the casing, there are three types of casing. Generally, mostly two types of casing, volute casing and vortex casing. So in this pump, in this diagram, we are using a volute casing. Volute casing is nothing but the area of casing is gradually increasing towards the delivery pipe. So what the this purpose is used to, whenever the pipe area is increases, what happen? Whenever the area of discharging flow is increases, the velocity is decreases. The velocity is increases means kinetic energy is decreases. While kinetic energy increases, pressure energy will be increases in the suction pipe. So this is a casing. So after centrifugal effect or centrifugal action of this impeller, the water is entered the casing of this pump. So the casing is a gradually increasing cross section. So gradually the velocity is decreases. While entered to the heavier cross section, the velocity is decreases. Due to the kinetic energy decreases, while pressure energy is increases, the pressure is rise. With the high pressure, the water is entered to the delivery pipe through delivery wall and a suction pipe. So this is a suction pipe. Suction pipe having a foot wall and strainer mechanism. The strainer mechanism is used to stop out the large particles or large dust particles, any unnecessary particles entered into the suction wall, suction pipe. So here is a suction valve as well. This is called non-returning valve. So this is a this valve. This is also in the delivery pipe also, and non-returning valve is used. This is a non-returning delivery valve. This is a non-returning suction valve. So while entered the water, the non-returning valve is used to stoppage of a reverse flow of the water while pump is not working. So in general, what happen? The valve is the non-return valve is open while pump is running. So the water is sucked to the impeller. So while the pump is stopping, what happen? The water in the casing may be back to the sump or come back to the delivery pipe to the casing, then impeller to the suction pipe. Here the non-return valve is used to stoppage of liquid flow back into the suction pipe. So this is a suction pipe and a delivery pipe. So delivery pipe is the one end of the delivery pipe is connected to the casing, and another end of the delivery pipe is connected to the overhead where you want to send the water or where you want to store the water. So that is a delivery pipe. So the delivery pipe also having a non-returning valve. This is only this non-returning valve only helps to the send the water to the delivery pipe to the upper head. While a pump is not working, when the water is come back to the delivery pipe through non-returning valve, here now the non-returning valve is does not open while water flowing to the reverse direction. Just water is stopped at a non-returning valve. These are the major components of centrifugal pump: impeller, casing, suction pipe, delivery pipe. Impeller having a impeller I. Through the impeller I, the water is entered from the suction pipe to the impeller I. Then it is due to centrifugal action while rotating, this impeller I is coupled to the motor or oil engine shaft. While rotating the shaft or impeller shaft, the impeller I is sucked the water through suction pipe. And the suction pipe through the suction pipe, the water is entered to the suction pipe through strainer as well as a foot wall. So then due to centrifugal action of this rotating or rotating of these blades, due to centrifugal effect, the water is entered to the strainer. then sorry that water is entered the casing. The casing has a diverging section, or this is called as a volute casing section. While the volute casing section is called, it is gradually increasing the while flow path of this fluid. While increasing the flow path, the velocity will be decreases, means the area of flow path is gradually increases. The area increases means velocity decreases. Velocity decreases means kinetic energy also decreases. While kinetic energy decreases, the pressure energy of the fluid is increases. Due to the high pressure energy, the water is lifted to the higher head or storage tank. So there is a, the pressure energy is converted to the potential energy. So these are the components of centrifugal, main components of centrifugal pump. So this is a suction pipe and delivery pipe. So coming to the working of both working and parts is the same. You can follow the working of a centrifugal pump or in my material or any of the notes. So this is about the centrifugal pump introduction and the classifications and advantages and the components of a centrifugal pump. So now I will explain our next topic is work done by the impeller. So how much this impeller is developing a work. So our next topic is work done by the impeller.